This part of the review for rituals for virtual meetings has to do with something that is particularly important. And that is the fact that sometimes the meeting is coming to a halt, not because energy isn't there or because relationships aren't strong, but maybe there's a little conflict, or maybe people are starting to get a little bit off track. After all, we've all got a lot going on these days. So again, one of the things that is really cool about this book is they give you the foundational basis for the ritual, but they also talk to you about exactly how to do it and give you some helpful hints about the timing. Now, as I've said before, I don't always agree with the timing that the authors have, but everybody's audiences and everybody's teams are a little bit different. So remember, these are just guidelines, always. As usual, the ISBN is going to be in the notes. So if you feel that you're getting something out of our review of this book, absolutely like and subscribe to us, but also take a look at the book itself. Fellow named Bruce Sutton said that it was the kind of book that he didn't even know he needed until he read it. And I tend to agree with him. So the first ritual that I want to talk to you about is called perspective pause. Now, this one is a particularly handy one to use if it turns out that as you're getting feedback from everybody in the room on certain issues or gaining their perspectives, things are not going the way that you would like them to go. So here's how to set it up. Now, first thing that you want to understand is that this is not supposed to be a long dissertation, all right? It's a series of questions that people are going to be encouraged to ask themselves so that they can move forward with the conversation in a much more productive fashion. Shouldn't take but more than about 5 or 6 minutes. And this is only going to work really, really well for you in a small group. Please don't try it in a larger team setting, okay? Now, empathy has been getting a lot of press, and it should be, but I think sometimes people mistake the depth that you need to go to when you truly want to be empathetic. A fellow by the name of Nicholas Epley pointed out that empathy needs more than just trying to put yourself in the other person's shoes. It actually might cause a little bit of a problem if you think that's all it needs, because then you're operating under the impression that you have a great deal more empathy and you understand that other person a great deal more than you really do. And that can be a bit of a problem. So perspective pause helps a lot. Okay. So it's based on the sense that you're going to ask yourself a couple of very specific questions during this 5 minutes for the perspective pause. One, what do you think each of the other people's perspectives actually is on the issues that are on the agenda for this meeting? Yeah, I know. Two, and this is very important. What would you feel is the most charitable explanation for what you guess is the other person's perspective? Because you want to assume good intent. Now, three, treat your guesses as hypothesis, as a thesis statement, and try to figure out how are you going to test the validity of your hypothesis during the course of the meeting, and what kinds of questions might you actually ask the other individuals in order to see if your assessment or your judgment calls were accurate. Remember, nobody's assessment is 100% accurate, and nobody's judgment calls are either. Now, the issue isn't that you're going to make sure people ask those questions. The issue is, having spent the 5 minutes and jotting down notes for themselves, they are much more likely to ask those questions, and that alone is going to help a great deal. Then there's something called the curiosity timeout, which I kind of like. Set it up and say, look, we've got a lot going on, and these issues that we're going to be addressing in this meeting are really important. So before we get started, I'd like you to take about 20 seconds and jot down your answer to this question. Given the topics on the agenda today, what is the one thing that you're most curious about? What is the one answer, in effect, you want? In effect, what is the question that you most want an answer to out of the proceedings of this meeting? Now, I like this because it, just let me put it this way. It's not that unusual for us to not have read the agenda to a meeting until we're actually logging into the meeting, which means we haven't given it as much thought as we maybe could have. So the curiosity timeout gives us an opportunity to actually process what's on the agenda. And I'll admit, sometimes the agenda, I wrote it and I haven't given any thought since I sent it out to everybody. I haven't actually given any thought to it since then. And well, those of you who worked with me know, I work really hard at walking my talk. So you know that agenda went out a couple of days ago. So the curiosity timeout serves me too. Yeah, just keeping everybody honest. These rituals, the beginning, how can we keep the flow and the cohesive kind of collaboration we need, are important. There's also going to be a video on rituals for ending a meeting in a productive and cohesive fashion, in a way that helps to strengthen the relationship between the team members and create a stronger sense of a team identity. I'm Kimihiro Tsuzimsky, and this video, along with all the others, has been brought to you by the Leadership Driven Project Management Academy group on Facebook. Please join us, and thank you for joining us for this video lesson.